sake of his sorrowful flesh.
Thou mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful flesh.
Thou mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful flesh.
Thou mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful flesh.
Thou mercy on us, O Lord.
For the sake of his sorrowful flesh.
Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For the Father, help in the body, blood, soul, and divinity, of your dear beloved Son, our Lord Jesus.
grace and the peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Morning, God.
Gathered around the table of the Lord, we ask the Lord for his blessings, his pardon, his peace, as we turn toward him, preparing to celebrate his holy mystery. Lord Jesus, you came in the fullness of time. Lord, have mercy.
Lord
Jesus, you came to fulfill the law to lead us to the promise of heaven. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you call us still by the Spirit, by sacraments and word. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing is firm foundation, nothing is holy. Bestow an abundance your mercy upon us and grant that,
with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. This word came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Rise up, be off to the potter's house. There, I will give you my message. I went down to the potter's house, and there he was, working on the wheel. Whenever the object of clay which he was making turned out badly in his hand, he tried it again, making of the clay another object of whatever sort he pleased. Then the word of the Lord came to me. Can I not do to you, house of Israel, as this potter has done, says the Lord? Indeed, like clay in the hand of the potter, so are you in my hand, house of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of
Jacob. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God while I live. Put not your trust in princes, in the sons of men in whom there is no salvation. When his spirit departs, he returns to his earth. On that day, his plants perish. Blessed he whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God, who made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them.
Blessed is he.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. You understand all these things? They answered, yes. And he replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. When Jesus finished these parables, he went away from there. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord.
Bringing out the new and the old from the storeroom, knowing when the clay has taken a turn that is not going to work, knowing when the clay has taken a turn that is going to work, bringing out both the old and the new. This is something that the church is charged with doing. This is something that the church does in its continuing effort to reform and renew. This is something that continues to guide us. It comes from the words of Christ himself. It requires the wisdom of the Spirit to discern. It requires a life that is dedicated to the Word and to the example that Christ himself gave. We gather together as the clay in the hands of the Father. We gather together as those who seek to be molded in God's ways, surprising ways, new ways, and old ways. We gather to grow. We gather to become one in the one who calls us, Christ our Lord.
Placing our needs before the Lord, we ask him to guide us as we present our prayer.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the souls of Bob Kowalski and David White. For these intentions, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, may she be continually blessed with an abundance of divine goodness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in the world who seek the truth, may the Holy Spirit bring them to know Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from unjust treatment or discrimination, may the Lord encourage them and deliver them from their trials. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to abortion and for the legal protection of unborn children everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our military troops engaged in dangerous missions, that they be protected by God watching over them, and returned safely to their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the young people of our faith community, may God guide and protect them amid the pressures in their lives. us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal petitions, let us pause in silence. For all of these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who celebrate birthdays this day, this week, this month, especially for Victor. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, who fill your people with a longing for you, guide us always. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit, vine, and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, and the praise of your Lord at his name, for our good and for all of us, the Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all prayers. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, light them and fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving it to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.